Good morning. You guys have already started the party. You guys are cracking me up in the comments. I love the Q-tip to swab the deck. Literally, Q-tip to swab the deck. Let me know how you guys are doing this morning. Oh, Raven, you only have 1 hour. Hi, everybody. Yeah, I had to start a little later. We're trying to do the kids' school in the morning, and luckily Friday's a little bit of an easier day for us, but I figured I could start by 11. So anyway, we are going to be painting this ship today, and I will give just a couple more minutes. But yeah, we usually start at 10, but today I'm starting at 11. Just worked a little bit better for our family schedule. So hi, everybody. I'm so glad to hear you're doing good. Yay. We're doing pretty good here, and we're just continuing day by day sometimes. Natalie, you're building the cardboard house. That's awesome. I have already seen so many people send me pictures of a cardboard couch, and that is just amazing. It makes me smile every single time to see so many people just like jumping on that project. And I mean, it really did go pretty quickly even when I was creating it. And so it's a pretty fast one to create. Renee says, sorry, I can't stay on my lunch break. Got 1 minute left. Hi, Renee. Thanks for joining us. Tea time in the UK. Yum. I've had my coffee and I had a granola bar, I think. I cut all my hair off. I don't know if y'all can tell, but I cut my hair because it was getting crazy. And I really haven't tried to look at the back very much, but I just went really slow and cut a little bit at a time. I had to. Yay, I'm so glad to see everyone here. I think I saw someone ask what colors. Noelle asked what colors. And so I'll show you kind of my inspiration. And there were a lot of people giving a lot of suggestions for colors, and I really like the idea of totally changing this up from a really dark ship to lighter colors. And I also watched Stardust again. I was about to say Stardust, which is a Neil Gaiman book that was translated into a movie. It wasn't translated. Transcripted. I don't know what the word is there. But they, in that movie slash book, there is a ship that actually catches lightning. And so it's actually a sky ship. So I'm not going to try and make it look exactly like that ship, but, I thought it would be cool to, turn this into like a lighter colored kind of sky inspired ship. And then put it into a sky scene, because I've never really made sky in miniature, so I thought that'd be kind of a cool challenge. So yeah, we'll try that. Have you heard from Heather lately? I sent her a PM with no response. I know she was ill and really miss her. I have heard from her. She's still not 100%. And even like I messaged her, and typically she writes a lot. She was still just writing just a little bit. And so I think she's just being careful with herself, which I think is really smart. And I think she wants to come back 100% and just be ready to go and ready to jump in and get started. So thank you guys for being patient with her, because I think it's really important that she takes care of herself. So I'm glad she's taking time to do that. Transmorgified? Transmogrified. Skyship sounds cool. Yay! Okay, so let me show you the colors. So of course I have white. I just grabbed a few colors off of my nicely organized paint thing. And then I have this Caribbean, is this one we mixed? No, I thought we mixed this one, but it doesn't have a name. Any of the ones that we mixed on stream, I have Abandoned Coffee, which I'm slowly running out of. Because I used it a lot on the cardboard house. This one, I think I mixed myself a long time ago, so who knows how old that is. And then gray. Can y'all see all of those? Hold on. So these are kind of my inspiration colors. So a little bit of wood, like light wood colors, and then some kind of sky colors. It's aged and weathered, broken down, but not period accurate. I do what I want. That's the nice thing about miniatures. You can make what you want. Sorry if I'm missing some comments. If you have a question, make sure to just repost it, and I'll try to keep up as much as I can. So those are my colors. I have a question about Mod Podge. What exactly is it? I don't know. I know there's like a homemade Mod Podge recipe online, which will kind of, it's a mixture of something plus PVA glue, which tacky glue is PVA glue. So that doesn't probably help you. But it really will, hold on, grab a paint palette. Hey, that's kind of a clean one. It's just kind of a sealant, and I have heard that it has, there goes Stormy barking at something, it has more of a water resistant, not waterproof, but it's a little bit more water resistant than PVA glue, but I'm not sure. I just need to know she's okay. I've made two of your cardboard sofas, and my grandchildren love them. Yay! That's awesome. All right. So I think I'm going to go ahead and put some paint colors in here. Yeah, we're 5 minutes past start time. So let's start some painting. And I also have the little stand that goes here. And I think that'll be really helpful. Obviously, it's not going to stay on this stand, but a lot of times when I'm painting, it's really hard to know where to put something down, especially if it doesn't have a flat surface on it, which this ship doesn't. So I think I'm just going to, usually I just put the paints out as I need them, but I'm really not 100% sure. I don't really have like a huge plan. This week I was actually working on trying to get the retro stove pattern for my store, to make it into a kit, and it doesn't want to be a kit, apparently. It's been giving me problems, so I'm definitely, I've had to kind of try something, and then backtrack, and then try again. It's a lovely noise. And so, it's been a process, and so it's definitely not ready for the store yet, but I am working on it, and that's kind of what I've been focusing on this week. Anytime I have a live stream week, it means I don't have to edit a video, which takes a ton of time. It's actually what takes up most of my time during the weekdays, and I don't know if I'm just a slow editor or what, but whenever I have a live stream, I don't have to edit, so I use that time to make kits for my store. Let's see. I like your creative cardboard house because I was like, I want to make a house, and your video came up, and I was like, yes, that's awesome. I think I'm really excited because I have seen people say they don't have access to a dollhouse kit, or they can't afford one, or they want to make their own, and so I'm really glad that's been helpful. Yay, first ever in the live chat. What are your thoughts on wet palettes and their use? I have never used a wet palette. I know what one is. I've never used one. I think I have a friend who only uses a wet palette. And I think it's to Sean, who's Dolphin Magic Pro. You can kind of explain better if I don't explain it very well. But it's like a container that I think there's like a moistened something in the bottom, and it keeps your paints wet and they don't dry out, like just putting it into a palette in the air. And so I have a friend who uses a wet palette, and she's been using the same paints for years and they've just never dried out. So, I mean, it seems really smart and it seems economical. And so she's made her own wet palette. There's ways that you can make them. But I've just never tried it. I've never actually put in the time to try it. Technically afternoon. Yeah, I guess, well, yeah, depending on where you are, it's definitely afternoon. For me, it's a little bit before noon. Loved your cardboard house. Busy collecting cardboard now. Yeah, my house, he's right here. He's hanging out, waiting for some more furniture. Need to store the bottle upside down in the container. Yeah, I probably need to do that too. Hi, cat. Will there be a new mini prompt soon? I guess I'm running out of ideas and inspiration. I actually thought about turning that second video into a prompt because one of my prompt words is tower. And I might still do that because I might have a video where I focus on the cardboard house tower. And I think it's a great opportunity to use the prompt word tower because it's such like a difficult word. So, anyway, I'm thinking about that. Y'all have to let me know. Is that cheating? Cause I already built the tower. Let me know what you think. Oh, Black Magic Craft has a whole video on wet palettes. So, thank you, Nikki. Hi, Janet. Hi, Jesse. All right. So I'm just going to start laying down a thin coat, and because this is made of paper, I think going with a thin coat is going to be the best bet because it's paper and I don't want it to bend and warp. Also, I wanted to let you guys know I didn't completely finish putting it together because there's pieces like this, which is supposed to be the ropes that hold these poles together. But I thought it would be a little bit harder to paint if I went ahead and put all these detail pieces on. So I haven't put those on. And then there's all these gold pieces that are supposed to go on. And I think there's a whole nother section. I don't know. Maybe this just goes on the back. Or this is a whole piece in itself, this gold piece. So I figured after I get a coat of paint that I like on here, then I can go back and add the details and figure out what of the rest of the pieces that I want to add. So I'm going to try and do thin coats of paint, but I'm not thinning it with water because water would just probably make any warping that's going to happen a lot worse. So I'm hoping this will kind of help any of you who I've heard a lot of comments that it was hard to see the details on this ship, which makes sense because it's completely black. I think it's supposed to be like the Black Pearl. Of course, they can't say that because copyright reasons. I think that was the inspiration for it. So I'm just starting with a very light coat of acrylic paint, and it's not going to look good until I start getting a few coats on here. But this will start to protect the paper. Just having a few coats of acrylic paint will start to protect it, and then I can do some heavier painting and heavier aging. My grandfather made sailing ships from scratch for his hobby. They are beautiful, and he carved and made everything himself. Wow. Do you still have them? Because that would be an amazing thing to like have like in the family. I remember my grandfather had a ship in a bottle, and I don't know if he put it together himself, but I remember it being in the hallway of his house, and I'm not quite sure what happened to it. Do you cook? Random question. I cook out of necessity. At one point in my life, I did enjoy it. And like I would cook my way through some recipe books. My favorite recipe book, this shows you how much I like to put into cooking, is, was it 6 ingredients or less? And so things made from 6 ingredients. And I like that book because it gives you the basics of how to put together a recipe. And then I could kind of add anything I wanted as I went along. And so it kind of like you were like, okay, if you at least put these 6 ingredients in, you will be able to create something. But then I could add my own ideas and stuff to the recipe. Yeah, details are already starting to emerge. Yeah, so you can see they have like little squares here that show you where to put. There's like these little cannon things. So yeah, it's a pretty detailed little kit, but it being all black does make it difficult to see all those details. So I think it's pretty cool. And it even has like some lines. I don't know if y'all be able to see those. No, I don't think you can see them. Maybe if I paint them a little bit more. There's like some lines engraved right where my fingernail is. But I'm afraid to hold on to these masts, I think is what they're called. Because I'm afraid I'll accidentally pull them off. Let's see. Are you painting the ship with abandoned coffee? Yep, I am. Abandoned coffee everywhere. I still have 3 of them sails rigging. Oh, that's awesome. If it doesn't microwave in 3 minutes or less, I don't eat it. If you stir it at some point, it counts as cooking. Today I met my wife. She married me because I can cook. Well, happy meeting anniversary. Happy anniversary. No, my husband did not marry me because I can cook. I can cook, but like I said, out of necessity. And I try to get a few vegetables in here and there. Okay, so our school district, which has been really awesome, has been providing meals for kids. Well, in the meals they've been providing, they give these bags of raw broccoli and raw celery, which is fine, healthy snack. But my kids they barely eat vegetables cooked. They eat them because I make them eat them. But they're definitely not going to eat them raw. So I took, 6 bags of broccoli, 6 bags of celery yesterday. And I just put them in the crock pot with a bunch of water and just set it to cook and then made it into a stew. And they ate it. They weren't super happy about it, but they ate it. So like I said, I kind of cook out of necessity. Favorite food? So my favorite food is something called green sauce. And I don't know if that's the official name or if it's just something that my family has called it. But there is a Mexican food restaurant called Los Cucos. They're actually isn't one around where I live. But there was one where I grew up. And they have green sauce. And they'll bring it out like at the beginning of the meal. Kind of like they'll bring a normal red salsa, but then they'll also bring this green sauce, and It is amazing. If you like cilantro, I know there's like a 50-50 split on people who like cilantro and people who don't like cilantro. But if you like cilantro, it is a delicious. And we would each ask for our own bowl. And I could honestly just sit there and eat green sauce. But I knew I wanted it at my wedding, so I had green sauce at my wedding, and I want it at my funeral. Those are my two requests. And then, of course, all in between because I want to eat it, but those were my two requests. At this point, it reminds me of Jabba's sail barge from Star Wars. Man, it's been years since I've watched Star Wars. All right. Try and quickly get the body covered. And I think I'll have to do the masts as well. I'm just a little nervous because they're really, really delicate. I guess that's what I get for making giant spikes from a single thing of paper. So it's just going to be very delicate. I'm hoping the acrylic paint will really kind of strengthen the entire model. But we'll see. I mean, it won't strengthen it enough for it to hold any weight or anything. I love cilantro. Let's see. Our school district is giving food to the kids. We have to go to the school to get it, and I'm too paranoid to let my kids go. Ours have started, you don't actually have to bring the kids. And so I'll go myself, and you just have to have proof that you have kids. and so you don't have to get the kids out. Yeah, I haven't been taking my kids anywhere. My kids touch too much stuff to go anywhere. Let's see. Do you like Star Wars? I'm going to make a blue milkshake. I do like Star Wars. And are you just using food coloring? That's interesting. You should try Brazilian food. Actually, I have had the Brazilian cheese rolls before, and they were amazing. And my family's been to Brazil. I have not been to Brazil, but my family's been to Brazil a couple times, and they love it. And honestly, I was pretty sure one of my sisters was not coming back because she loved it so much. She did come back, but they really love Brazil. What got you doing minis? Well, I started, some of you may know this. I started doing minis because I had to for school. Sorry if I'm on off screen here. But you can really start to see the details in the model now that I'm painting up front. That's not something you could see before at all. I'll go ahead and, what is this one called? Is this still called a mast? Or is it like I'm going to say a nose, but I don't know. I started because I went to school for architecture and you have to build models. And usually they put you in groups. And so one person does like the 2D design and somebody does the poster, somebody does the paper, and then somebody does the model. And I was always the model person. And I loved it. Like, that was what I wanted to do, is I wanted to build the model. And then when I got out of college and I went to work at an architecture firm, which was good. It was great experience. And, you know, I learned a lot from there, especially now that I'm designing my own kits. Like, I know how to draw detailed drawings in 2D that results in something that's 3D. So I definitely appreciate my time learning those skills, but I missed building models. And even while I was working at the architecture firm, I started working for a theater set designer who worked on theater sets, and I started building models of the sets for her for the plays that she was working on, and I really loved it. And then I moved and I wasn't working with her anymore. And so one day I just went to Hobby Lobby and they had like a coupon and I purchased the first part of the Addams Family house. So And then the rest was history, I guess. Sorry, I'm missing some stuff. Do you do gardening? Nope. I do not. I have a couple indoor plants. But they are ones that really only need attention every now and then. If they need regular attention, they're in danger in my house. Sorry, I hit the microphone. Here you can see some of the detail inside the ship. And I'll probably be able to paint a little faster once I have this first coat on. Yeah, some people, I see y'all talking about, cilantro. Some people say cilantro tastes like soap. I think it's like a genetic thing. It's either you like the taste or it tastes like soap to you. So it's something that you have to try and see if it works with your specific taste buds. For some reason, it works really well with my taste buds. But there's some people who, like, if cilantro is in their food at all, I mean, it just tastes like they're chewing on a bar of soap and they just hate it. And there's like not really a way to change that. I think literally that's in your DNA, I think. Let's see. It's amazing how we sometimes fall into miniatures and it starts as a harmless hobby and then it takes over. Yeah, I literally have an entire room in my house. It has taken over, but thankfully, it's turned into a job for me. So I'm very, very thankful for that. And I'm thankful to you guys for making that a possibility. And, you know, I just was thinking the other day how awesome it is that I get to do something I love. And so I really appreciate that. That's exactly what my husband says, and he can't stand it. Yep. So it's something genetic in the DNA, I'm not quite sure, that makes people just, I think there's some people who are just like, not a big fan or don't care about cilantro, but there's some people who just really, really hate it a lot. All right, we're almost done with the deck here. If I get any of these ship terms incorrect, please let me know. And I'll quickly, sorry if this is getting boring, me just putting the first coat on here. But we'll start making it a little bit more interesting. Like, I think I want to make it look a little bit like, so I definitely want to make it look old because that's my favorite thing to do. But then maybe like at one point it had been painted to match the clouds so that they could camouflage themselves. But it had maybe started to wear off. So something like that. These pieces up here, this little, I think it's called a crow's nest. Very, very delicate. And even now I'm like, please don't break. Please don't break. I could probably have hardened it with some super glue, but I don't know. That probably would have been a good thing to do. Oops. my other half always says about my love of miniatures, what is it about you and small stuff? Yep. Well, and it turns into a big hobby somehow. It's small stuff that turns into a big hobby. Takes up some space. I can draw you the captain. What do you want the captain to look like? I picture the captain to be kind of a mixture of like a typical 17th century ship captain with like the coats and maybe like a hat and everything, but then also kind of mixed with Star-Lord from the Avengers. So I don't know if you know his character, but those two mixed together. I don't know if that makes sense. Oh, it's one of the questions they ask you if you like cilantro. It's interesting. Oops seems to be my favorite word with miniatures. Yeah. Or other words. Like when you sneeze and everything you just been working on flew all over the place and you have to go searching for it. And you're trying to beat the dog to finding it. I'm one of those unfortunates that cilantro tastes like soap. Drives my brother nuts. He loves to cook with it. Aww. All right. So, we're getting close here. So, what do y'all think? Should I try and do another coat? Sorry, I'm getting off screen here. Should I try and do another coat of the brown to make this solid? Or do we kind of like the black showing through? Because I think I kind of like the black showing through. And then I can, like, I think it gives it that age look. Like, and I'm not even trying to paint it very well. It's just kind of naturally looking really old with the black paper showing through. I see Janet said, did you make the ship? The ship is from a kit from the company Paper Nano. And it's something I had in my collection like for a long time. And there was one day I was just like, I can't work on the Fairfield project for a while because I was just going a little bit crazy. And so I pulled out this and we just started working on it. So that's where it came from. So it's not my original design. But we're going to make it our own by putting it into, we're painting it, which I don't think it's meant to be painted. And then we're going to put it into a scene and just kind of make it our own little, our own ship. okay, so you guys like the black showing through. That's good. One of the hardest things to do is getting rid of your art. Definitely. That is really, really hard. I try to rehome things before I get rid of things because I'd rather know that somebody is getting use out of it. But that's definitely hard. All right, so let me get... Okay, I think everyone's liking the black showing through. And then a little bit... Yeah, we can kind of put a little bit lighter in certain places, but not do like a solid coat of brown. Since the old ship's wood was tar coated to make it more waterproof, should be darker. Looks more like a ghost ship with the black showing through. Bye, Vanessa. Thanks for joining us. After you edit and publish your videos, do you keep your footage or do you delete it? I keep the edited video and then I delete the individual clips because oftentimes before I edit a video, I have hours of video of me working on something, especially if I know I'm going to speed something up. So like if I was going to paint this ship but then speed it up, I would have an hour of video of me painting the ship, but then in my edited video, it's only like 10 seconds because I sped it up. So I'll keep the finished video, but then delete all of the raw footage after I know that the video went well and I don't need that footage anymore. So there's kind of a grace period where I keep it for a little bit, but then once the video's been up for a month or so, I'll go back and delete that just to save space on my computer because video takes up so much space. And I'm actually trying to look into some more space saving or some more memory. There we go. Computer words. Memory for my computer. I can't bear to part with anything I'll make. I'll try to rehome my sofa. Oh, I'll need to rehome my sofa. A blooper reel would be hysterical. Yeah, if there is kind of a big blunder, I like to leave it into the video. But sometimes you can't even see, like, I'll make a blooper or a mistake, but I'm like, oh, it was off camera. And sometimes I'll explain what happened, but oftentimes it's me trying to cut something and it goes flying across the room and then I just have to cut it again. That's half the problem, is your stuff is so lightweight that it just disappears. This mast isn't super, super straight. That's okay. All right. So I think we've got, we need to do the top of this piece here. I think we've got most of it painted here. And yeah, we're looking good. Okay. So we might go back and lightly dust it. Whoops. Doesn't want to go on its stand here. Be on the stand. Okay, let me find my water. I have like so many jars here. How did you start making tutorial videos? So, I don't really know if I have a good answer to that question. Well, my channel originally started out as an art channel. And so I did more art, like 2D art, like drawing and painting, than I did miniatures. Even though I was still doing miniatures in the background just as much as I was doing art. But then I realized there was more of a need or more room for art, for miniature videos than there were for art videos. And those videos were just getting a lot more views. And I realized people really wanted and needed miniature tutorials and miniature ideas, because there just happens to be a lot more art channels than there are miniature channels. And so that's when I kind of made a switch and I started working mostly on miniatures. I think the only art videos I've done have been making like miniature paintings, which is art, and miniatures are art, but when I'm referring to art, I'm referring to 2D art. I guess that's kind of how I got started. I recently thought, because I saw someone else react to their first video, and I'm like, I should totally react to my first tutorial because it is private right now, and I haven't watched it just in case I want to react to it because I want to get my genuine reactions. But I don't know. I can't remember if it's good or not. The result is kind of but it could be a fun one for some week where I'm just feeling a little bit overwhelmed and can't get a full tutorial out. I might do a reacting to my first miniature tutorial. So I'm going to find a brush to do some dry brushing on this guy. Let's see. Are you going to add a sail, like cloth thing? There are sails that come in this kit. I don't know if I'm going to use these or if I should use actual cloth. I don't know if you can see that, but it kind of just looks like a mesh. It doesn't really look like a sail. Here's the picture of when you put the sails on. I mean, if you're just using a paper model, I think that's a great solution for putting sails on it. But if I want mine to look realistic, I might have to use cloth. And then of course I can like tear it up and, make it look like really old and stuff. You guys want to see the react to my first tutorial? Now I have to go find a bus. Okay. Found some mini double decker bus that are going cheap, so I cut them. Oh, okay, so that's why you're saying you have to go find a bus. Gotcha. Luckily, I've got enough to make one too. Wow. Cool. I found you via Jazz and have become hooked. Well, thank you for coming over and checking out my channel. Yeah, I'm so thankful that Jazza chose my video. It's still kind of mind-boggling every now and then. because I've watched him even before I had my own channel. I remember watching Jazza. He was one of the first channels I subscribed to because he had a lot of drawing tutorials. And he doesn't do that so much anymore, but I've watched him forever. So having my video featured on his channel was just kind of one of those out-of-body wow experiences. So I'm very, very thankful for that. React to your second video. Put tattered sails on the React. Sounds good. Okay. Yeah, I'll have to do the tattered sails then. Unless you use cloth, it would have to be super lightweight. I'm actually thinking about using dried out baby wipes because I've heard people use those and they really like them. So I might try those. I have a couple packs because I have kids, so we tend to have baby wipes. We don't have any anymore because they haven't been available, but I have, they usually by like the last two or three they run dry, and usually I'll re-wet them and just use them to like wipe down a counter or something. But I've saved them so I can keep them to try and use them in a miniature project, so I might try that. So hi Donita. Oh, thank you, Lucy. Deborah, you're asking who is Jazza? Jazza is a art creator. So if you watch any kind of art YouTube, you've probably heard his name. But if you just watch miniatures, I don't think he does a ton of miniatures, but he does like miniature, like Warcraft type miniatures. So like the gaming miniatures. He's been talking about that recently. Okay, so all I'm doing is I'm taking this like lighter cream color and I'm just dabbing like most of it off, and I'm just gonna lightly go over it, and this is going to make some of those details come out even more. And I mean like super, super light. And I think this will kind of give that dried out, very dried out wood appearance, especially because this is a ship that's in the air. It's not gonna have that wet, dark look from the water because it's been in the air for so long. So we may have to give it a few lightning strike burns or something. All right, so I'll put this on here. I saw someone use coffee for a second I read it as coffee stirrers. I was like, that's interesting. How did they do that? But coffee filters make sense. Jazza is a madman who can make art out of literal trash. Correct. Oh, wet tissue paper. That's a good idea. I have some of that too. All right. So I'm just going to gently go over everything here. And really, I don't need... See, I always pour way more paint than I need, which is why I have a teeny tiny palette somewhere. I need to get it back out to control my paint pouring tendencies. Okay. I'm trying to get in there. Oops. So here's with the dry brush on top, and then here's without. So you can kind of see it gives it just a little bit of a highlight, and I think it gives it a little bit more depth when you add a third color. So here we have the black showing through and the brown, and then this has that third color, which is the highlight, and I think it pops that realism to just give it that one extra little bit of color, I think, in my opinion. I've used coffee stained paper in some of my projects, like aged window shades. Oh, that's smart. I've been playing Slime Rancher recently. It's a cute ranching game. I have never heard of that one. I was playing Farmville. I think that was a game that was popular a while ago, but it's still around. I just kind of needed a game that was like a brain break, like something that wasn't miniature related, wasn't reading, wasn't, it was just pure something that was going to result in nothing. And it just, I played that for a while, but I haven't been back on there for a little bit. It just needed something that wasn't work, wasn't anything. And so that was kind of nice to have that brain break. Always pour more, way more paint. Yep. It's a problem with miniatures too. You just, I mean, I guess it's not a problem. It's a good thing. You don't need a ton of paint. Unless you're painting an entire house, then you do. Yes, Deborah, the lightning ship from the movie Stardust. I'm not trying to recreate that ship. Oops. Well, there's a blooper for you. I just stuck the entire front of the ship in the paint. I'm not trying to recreate that ship, just something kind of based off of that idea, like a skyship. I think Captain Hook also had a skyship, didn't he? Like it just like floated around. I think he had a skyship. I don't know if that was in the cartoon that my kids watched. What was that called? Pirates? I can't remember. There was a little cartoon on like the Disney Channel that was based off of, it was based off of the pirates point of view. It wasn't based off of Peter Pan. And the kids were, I don't know. I can't remember. So, all right. So I'm going to try and dry brush a little bit in here. It is I'm really glad I didn't put those other pieces on there, or I would have no luck getting into these little spaces on here at all. If I do go back, I think I will go back with a detail brush and try to hit some of these wood panels individually, because you can kind of see them, but I think if I hit them with just some paint, like they would, it would show up a little bit more as individual planks. What scale is the ship? I have no idea. It'll tell you. Okay, the finished size is 160 millimeters tall by 145 millimeters wide. So I'm sure it's probably a railroad scale. It's probably not one of the dollhouse scales. Railroad scales get a lot smaller. Well, except for one and 144th scale. Jake and the Neverland Pirates. Thank you, guys. That's correct. That's what it is. All right, so I'm just going to barely touch the cream paint on the masts here. I may have to reinforce these. I'm sure if I put the little paper ropes that they provide on here, it does support them. I just haven't added those yet so that I can paint it easier. I'm sure if I added those, it would have a lot more support. So it's probably just because I'm not doing the kit like they designed it that it's kind of wobbly. What is your opinion on honey? Like the food? Or do you mean the website? Because I think there's like a honey browser that's supposed to get you money back. They haven't wanted to sponsor me. Wet toilet paper and Mod Podge layers make a great water feature. Cover it with a thin layer of UV resin and it's realistic. I'll have to try that. I love learning new things with resin, especially when they work well and are like easy, quick and easy to do. Hi, Moose. If you can find handkerchief material, that will be much finer, or the coffee filters. Do we have some handkerchiefs? My husband may have some. He doesn't really carry handkerchiefs, so I can ask him if he has any. Will you put it in a bottle? No, I think I'll put it, probably make a scene. And I was even thinking, I was like, you know what? I could use cardboard to make a little, so like if he's this big, I was thinking maybe a scene, not much bigger, but just him kind of floating in the clouds and make it look like clouds are just kind of engulfing this ship. It's kind of my idea. I don't know. You have to let me know what you think. Honey as in the food. I like honey. I mean, it's not something that we have a lot in the house, but I think it's good. And I like bees. They're pretty cool. It looks like a smaller ship to start and then it gets shrunken down. They may design it much bigger. Front angle mast is called a bowsprit or a bowsprit? Interesting. Okay. So let me give you an up close view. I really do think painting it brings out all the details. When it was just black paper, you could not see anything. But it is really a little, I mean, it's even got a little door and windows in there. And you can't see any of that at all. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to try my idea of going back with a smaller brush and just hitting one little bit at a time, one little panel, and see if we like how that looks. I'm gonna try and do this so that y'all can see too. This may not be worth my time, but we'll see. So every now and then, just make a little, paint a little piece like that. We'll try it for couple of them and see what we think. That is one thing. If any of you are thinking about starting a miniatures channel, I know y'all were asking me about tutorials earlier. There is a fine art to being able to see what you're doing and also allow the camera to see what you're doing at the same time. And it doesn't always work out. Sometimes it comes out with your head being in frame or you didn't show what you really wanted to show, so you got to show it again. After it dries, it kind of mats down. So I think that could work, just to show a little bit more of the texture on there. Favorite color combination. I don't know. I pretty much like brown and anything together. And that's kind of maybe a little bit boring, but I like things that are antique looking. So anything that looks like it's got like wood showing through the paint. I really like, so antique colors are probably my favorite colors, like avocado greens and tans and stuff like that. So I don't know if that's boring, but that's what I like. So I think that just brings out the little planks. Put this ship in a background scene for the captain's cabin. You can fiddle with perspective to make it look real. That is an interesting idea. I would have to have quite a big like back panel behind it. That is an interesting idea. I'll have to think about that. That would be kind of cool. I don't know what it is about ships. It's just so fascinating. I've been on a ship, but it wasn't like a ship like this. But there's something about ships and sails and just the old kind of type of ships that are just so fascinating to me. All right, I'm just going to do them every so often. Maybe these are the planks that recently got replaced. And so they just look a little bit newer. All And I think it just gives a little bit more direction to show you that the planks are going this way, since some of the detail gets a little bit lost in my dry brushing. This just kind of reinforces the wood pattern on the deck. Okay. Like so. The 70s. All right, talking about my favorite color combinations is the 70s. Yeah. Probably the 70s, but more muted. Not as bright and in your face as the 70s. Maybe that's why I started doing the Fairfield in the 70s theme, because I wanted to be able to use all my favorite colors. I toured a reproduction of the Mayflower, and that was fascinating. That does sound cool. We were supposed to go on a ship when we were near Galveston, but it got canceled for some reason. Sad. Okay. I think that's all I'm going to do for now here. I might go back over this guy so he stands out a little bit more, maybe. Okay. So what should we do next? This is where I'm going to get stuck, because I like how it's looking, but I still have this blue and gray here. So I'm wondering if I should paint it like patches, so it looked like there used to be some kind of painting over it. Or, I don't know. Let me know what y'all think. What are you using as a reference for your captain's quarters build? Really, I'm just searching images. So anything I want to create. So for like the captain's bed, I looked up 17th century ship captain's bed or captain's quarters. And what's interesting is I found a lot of game images, so images that come from, I don't know what game it is. If I can figure out what game it is, I probably should play that game. But game designers' versions of 17th century captain's quarters. And so that was kind of cool to bring in some of those ideas as well. Of course, theirs is a little bit more cartoony, so I try and look for the realistic images. So a lot of times it's looking at like multiple images of what it actually looked like or what someone interprets it to look like, and then I kind of make my own design off of that. So it's going to be a pain to detail. Yeah, blue on the lower half with gray over it, dry brush to make it harder to see from the ground if the ship is sailing the skies. Well, that makes sense that they would want to they would want to camouflage from underneath. Yeah, it was interesting. One of y'all sent me a video about a Swedish ship, and I watched it. And they had a comparison of the ship now, because it's, you know, very old ship, and they had pulled it off the bottom of the sea. And, but they were showing a comparison of how it was painted previously, because they had painted it really, really brightly. So, let's see. Does the sprite statue at the front? Yes, it does. Let's see if I can get it to focus. It has an angel holding something. And I think there is, yeah. So when it's done, there's a gold piece that goes on it to have it like stand out. So that's the shape of the statue that goes on the front. Have a good Mother's Day. Yeah, Mother's Day is coming up. Woohoo! I'm going to stay in bed and play video games all day. That's my plan. Obra Dinn is basically a tour around an early 19th century boat with mystery twist. Ooh. Is that a movie? A TV show? The Vasa. I can't remember how they said it, but yes, that was the name of the ship. So if you look up VASA, that was the name of the ship I was talking about that was underwater. It like sunk immediately or pretty quickly, which was devastating to a lot of the people who were on it because they passed away. But then after several years of it being below the ocean, they brought it back up and it was mostly intact. But then they showed what it probably looked like with color. Ironic to have an angel on the front of the pirate ship. And it's actually kind of interesting now that you say that, because if it's a ship in the sky, that's kind of cool to have an angel on it. Google One-Eyed Willy ship from the Goonies. I have not seen the Goonies in years. Bye, Ravenwolf. Happy Mother's Day. All right, so I am going to, we'll start over here on the back, and I'll start to try and figure out what we're going to do with this blue and white and see if we like it, because I'm not completely sure about what I want, so we'll figure it out. Hi, Leslie. We just painted this ship. And now we're going to try and figure out how to make it a sky-themed ship. So, all right. So I'm going to start light. And that's my biggest suggestion when it comes to painting miniatures, is start light. And so I'm just going to get a lot of white off here. I'm going to start back here. Because I want to make it look as though at one point this was painted. And it's starting to come off, revealing the wood of the ship. So I'm starting pretty light, like so. And I can always go back and add more, but it's harder to take it off, because to take it off, I'd have to repaint this whole thing, starting with a layer of black to make it match everything else. So it's better to start light and then build up. Okay, so I think that looks like white paint that's started to come off. So let me know what y'all think. Hard to think that the big brother on Goonies is fond of playing Santos in the Marvel movies. I must be behind on my Marvel movies, because I'm not quite sure that character. So I'm liking that, so I'm going to continue it up a little bit. Like so. Do, 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 do. The Vasa was too fancy and top heavy, so that's why it sunk. Yeah, that was a sad story. It's cool to see the ship, but sad the story that goes along with it. Thank you, Pamelia. Okay, here we go. Now we're going to try some blue and see what we can do with that. I'm also dabbing most of that off. And I'm just going to put it a little bit here and there. Like so. Do we like that? Do we not like that? I guess we should probably let it dry just to give it a fair chance, because right now it's a little bit shiny. Okay, so if it were up in the sky and you were looking up, it'd look like this. No worries, we just were painting our little ship. Hi, Martha. Martha. I'm making a ship using the HMS Leopard and the HMS Victory as references. Awesome. Are you making it from wood? Or how much has the stream been going? The stream has been going for about an hour. So I'm not using my normal stream times just because I'm having to kind of fit everything around our family schedule because my entire family is home right now and we're trying to get through school. And so I appreciate y'all being kind of flexible with me on the live stream times as we figure that out. All right, I'm going to go back over and just kind of break up some of the blue here. So I just kind of really want a hint of the blue. See. You have 1,000 projects waiting to go. I feel you there. I have to restrain myself. Obviously, I don't restrain myself very well because I made the cardboard house when I haven't touched the atoms or the captain's quarters in a while. It's hard when you get an idea and you're just like, man, I really, really want to make that right now. It's hard. So I'm going to put a little bit up here on the front. I want to have some of this still showing through. So here's the difference of with the blue on top of the white, and this is just the white. Have you traveled to other parts of the world? I have lived in other parts of the world, actually. I have lived in South Africa. I've lived in Saudi Arabia, and I've lived in the Caribbean. And for a short time, I lived in Italy. So, yeah. I really love visiting other parts of the world. All right. So let me know what y'all think. And this was all when Italy was when I was college age. And then the other ones were when I was younger. And so those were all super happy memories in my childhood. Blue does the trick. Oh, this time is good for Europe. That is good to know, because it's always hard to time zones throw me off all the time. Two funeral wagon kits. That's going to be fun. Is that from Petite Properties? Okay. So I'm going to put a little bit of blue here. Top. Like so. So it's kind of looking like this. I think it makes sense to have some of the most outer edge rubbed off, because if they rubbed up against something, it would rub it off right here, I would think. I'm just guessing. Okay. So I think I'll put a little bit over here. And I think this part of the kit, this right here, is actually the captain's quarters of this ship. And I think it's supposed to go on the back right here. So I don't know if it'll stay gold. It might be kind of in your face a little bit. All right, so I'm gonna go with a little bit more white. Thank you, Jillian. Jesse says it's 12:05. Is that midnight 12:05? Because then you're exactly 12 hours away from me. So I'm going to add a little bit from the edge here, and I'm pulling towards the center. And that's kind of white mixed with blue. That point. I think it's, I like it. I think it's kind of, you can tell that it was once painted, and now you can kind of see the wood where it's touched a lot, the wood's kind of shining through. You're in the dentist chair. Oh my goodness. I'm glad they're letting you watch YouTube at the dentist. I'm not sure if my dentist would let me. 5 past noon. Oh, okay. We're on the same time zone. Going to be referring back to this video with great enthusiasm to finish painting my cardboard ship. Need some tips on the sails though. Yeah, we'll do the sails together. I think in the next live stream, or at least I'll prep them to kind of figure out what I want to do, and then we'll do like the last few together. That way you guys aren't having to sit here and watch glue dry. but I can show you what I decided to come up with. But I got several ideas from y'all, so I'll have to try them out. Era, I thought you were pretty much done with the Adams family house. Do you have a lot left? Well, it's like the never-ending project where it's like I don't really know what to do next. I have to finish Cousin It's room. And because it, I guess I've kind of been putting it off a little bit because its room has to be done really, really well and really nice. I can't just like mess it up and make it look all old and grungy like the rest of the house. And that's not my favorite way to make miniatures. Is to make everything look nice and pretty, but that's the way its room is in the video, in the movie, or I guess you don't see his room in the movie. You see his room in the TV show. And so in the TV show, like his bed is made, his furniture is nice. He's got the nicest room in the house. And so I just need to get in a headspace where I'm okay with putting in the time, like making grunge miniatures takes time and it takes a lot of attention to detail, but you can be a little bit more sloppy because you can just cover it up with some stuff, which is why I like it. But when you're trying to make something look perfect and not grungy, it takes a little bit more just control and focus to make sure that you get it right, if that makes sense. Okay. So I kind of like that. I don't think I want to do any more than that. I don't know. You'll have to let me know what you guys think. What band or songs do you listen to most? Well, I don't know. Some of y'all may not like me that much after I say this, but I don't listen to a lot of music. I listen to more podcasts. And I listen to audiobooks. I think the reason that happened is because I think it was for seven or 10 years, I drove a car that didn't have a radio. And didn't have air conditioning, didn't have radio. I was very thankful to have that car. But during that time where most people were probably listening to music and listening to radio, I was just listening to my own thoughts basically. And so then when I was able to have a car that did have radio and music that and had a player that I could play music on, it felt really loud and I felt like I couldn't hear my own thoughts. And from then on, I couldn't really listen to music. I feel like if I want to think about something, I have to turn the music off. Which is weird because it's the same thing with audiobooks. Like, I still have to turn it off. But for some reason, just music feels very intrusive in my brain. So when I want to kind of shut off, I can put music on. Like, if I have to clean or something, I like having music on. But anyway, I don't know. Did that make sense? That makes sense. So I don't listen to a ton of music. If I do listen to music, it's usually like old time music, like Michael Bublé. I like Michael Bublé. And like I'll listen to Patsy Cline. We have a Patsy Cline record that I really like. Or, yeah, so older music, I think. Let's see. Cat and A for Apple are trying to talk. A for Apple, do you want me to show your email? Or do you want to get in touch on my Facebook books, on my Facebook, so that not everyone sees your email? So let me know if you want to try and get touch a different way. Otherwise, I'll hit show and then everyone will see it. So just let me know. Because I don't want to show your email if you're not wanting everyone to see it. You can probably find each other on my Facebook page. See. Oh. I listen to similar music. I clean to it. I must pay attention to it, so I can't have it in the background. But I love it, especially when I listen to it. Hold upside down to the camera so we see it from below. So this is what it's looking like. And I think if that was high up in the clouds, that would probably be pretty hard to see, I would think. Kind of blend in with the clouds a little bit. So I need to do a little bit more up here, I think. Okay, awesome. Y'all, if you go to the community tab and just post who you're looking for, then y'all find each other. Oh, thank you, Megan. It's so funny that when I get comments that people like my voice and like listening to it, because it's always been something that I haven't been a super fan of myself. So it's interesting to see people say that they like my voice. My zodiac, I think I am a Capricorn. Yes, I'm a Capricorn. So let me go here. I had to clean my brush off a little bit because I was getting a little bit too much blue, and so I wasn't getting any white. Because there was blue, like, up in the bristles. Alright, so I'm going to kind of do the same thing where I'm going to leave the most outer edge a little bit more brown than the rest of it. Because if he was sailing the ship and it went up against a mountain or a building or whatever happens to be way up in the air, it would rub the paint off of the furthest sides. So, just get all over here, get the white paint on here. I so want you to make a Victorian era luxury train car. Oh my goodness, that sounds like it would be amazing. And it makes me think of the movie Wild Wild West with Will Smith. That's just immediately what popped into my head. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? 5 years. I hope I'm still doing what I'm doing now. But I hope at that time that things will have continued to grow and I can, be even more of a support to my family through continuing to do this. And so that's what's really fun about, having my store. I do want in the next 5 years, my store to grow, and in my store growing, I want to be able to go to more miniature shows around. Like, I don't know how it works with taxes, and like if I could go to like the Kensington Dollhouse Festival in England, and if I could sell there, if they would allow that, I don't really know. But I would love to just like travel in the name of miniatures and go to a bunch of different dollhouse shows and meet you guys and meet people around the world, but then also at the same time, you know, maybe have a table there and sell some of my kits. Like, I just think that would be so much fun. And like, bring my husband with me, and we could just, probably my kids too, if they were old enough to handle that kind of a trip. That would be cool if you read books in audiobooks. Oh my goodness. I've started reading some of my stories for my patrons. And so I've done kind of like a podcast on my Patreon. And so I've been reading these little stories that I've written. And I was thinking while I was recording that, I'm like, I could never do this as a profession because like I would, like, I don't know how many times I had to stop and restart the recording, and I got so frustrated. So I have mad respect for those recording artists that record audiobooks, because my goodness, it is not an easy task to, like, I just keep stumbling over words. I stumble over words normally, but then I just, for some reason, when I know I can't stumble over my words, I stumble over them even more. let's see. How would the ship fly? Any special machinery or ghost ship? I'm not sure how the ship in Stardust was meant to fly, except maybe it was just a magical ship. But it had like these big like metal wings that came out of the side, and that's what collected the lightning. There we go. That's the word. And so I don't know if I'll add those. They're pretty cool looking. I probably have to make them out of like paper clips or something. Oops, I almost got a little too rough there. But I think that's good. I got a little too crazy up here with the blue paint. I don't think I need any on the top because obviously you don't need to camouflage yourself from the top. So that's maybe a little overboard right there. What state are you in? I am in Texas. Let's see. Did you know there is a miniature show held in Oklahoma? I did not know that, actually. I would probably try to go to that one. I have family in Oklahoma. My brother's teacher was at our house to say hi. Oh, that's so sweet. Here in Chicago, we have Fairy Tale Castle. I have seen it! I've been there. I used to live in Plainfield, which is about an hour south of Chicago. So we would go to the museums in Chicago, and I always wanted to go see Colleen Moore's Fairy Tale Castle, and I would stand there and look at it for so long, and everyone would be like, come on, let's go, because they wanted to go to other parts of the museum, and I love that. See, I think you should try it. Ask for donations of special pieces or old jewelry to add to your own castle. Similar to the one we have in Chicago, if you know the story of the one woman that made that. I do. I volunteer on 3 Victorian first class cars. Ooh, that's exciting. A diner. That sounds exciting. Ship powered by bees. Hey, you know, they could hold the ship up. They're pretty strong bees. I brought my husband to one miniature show. I wanted to see all the booths and tables, but he was in construction and kept talking to people building homes in miniature. I've brought my husband, and he'll walk around with me once, and he'll look at everything because he finds it fascinating too. And he's really sweet. He'll come with me, but then usually he finds a nice place to sit, and then he waits for me to walk around and talk to people, and so. He likes it for a limited amount of time. Let's see. Used to be in Bowling Brook. We used to play them through school. My conference in Dallas just got canceled. I know they're canceling everything. The underside of the United States Air Force planes are gray on top and lighter gray on the bottom. Interesting. All right, so I'll read more comments. I gotta figure out what the next step is here. So I think it's looking pretty good down below. Do you think we should start seeing if we want to add any of these gold pieces on? I think that might be just something to see because I've held off on these guys. I don't know. Do you think the gold will go well with this? Because gold's not really like a camouflage color. So. Thank you, Trent. Yeah, I've been enjoying the books that people have been sending in so much. It's literally my favorite thing. And I think whatever project we do next, I'm going to have to find something else because that y'all could make and send in because it's been so much fun. And I hope you guys are having fun with it too. I hid the chat a while ago, so for 10 minutes I've been looking for how to make the chat show up again. I'm sorry. There's a massive miniature fair in Berlin. That would be so fun to go just to all the miniature places. Do you think miniature can be for all types of ages? Definitely, for sure. I mean, because I've done classes for kids making miniatures. You just kind of have to make sure that it's age appropriate for their skill level and let the kids just have fun with it to begin with. And then, of course, yeah, anyone can do it. Let's see. Do you have a story behind the captain's apartment, like the story behind the coffee shop? Yes, I don't have one yet. I'm going to start cutting this out so my head's going to be down. I saw someone ask, this is the kit that we're putting together and we're painting it. I don't think you're supposed to paint it, but that's what we're doing. So it's Paper Nano Black Pirate Ship. And I'm going to start cutting this out. What was the question? Oh, the story. Yes, I am going to be writing a story for the captain's quarters, just like I did for the abandoned coffee shop. And back to the question earlier that someone asked, where do I see myself in 5 years? I would love to do some kind of mashup project between writing a story and a miniature kit where there's like a book and a kit that goes together and you can build the project that's like the main focus of the story, like as you read. Like, do you think that would be cool or is that a strange idea? Because I think that's something I want to do at some point. And I don't know if 5 years is a realistic goal for that. But I think that would be really cool. Because it would be a mashup of two things that I really like, which would be writing and creating stories and history behind things. But then also having a physical, like there's something about holding a physical place, a physical object that's so magical, I think. And that's why I think I like miniatures. Okay, try and cut this guy out. Let's see how many little things I missed cutting through. Here we go. Whatever laser cutter they're using for this is just like the best laser cutter I've ever seen. Do paper crafts count as miniatures? Yeah, I mean, I don't want to be someone who's like, this is miniatures, this is not miniatures, this is art, this is not art. But I think create what you want to create. Have fun and enjoy it. And if you want to use a kit, use a kit. If you want to create it from scratch, create it from scratch. As long as you're enjoying what you're creating, then do it. That's my opinion. Bye, Jesse. Sorry if I'm missing some things. Mouse Mansion is a channel that is doing that on a kid level. Needless to say, I bought the book. Yes, Mouse Mansion. I have followed their accounts. I do want to get their book at some point. because that, like, I don't know if y'all have seen this Mouse Mansion thing, but it is huge, huge. It's a physically built multiple story room with these little mice, and it is the most adorable thing I've ever seen and the most impressive thing I've ever seen, just to continue with this project over the years. And so, yes, I do need to get that book. Okay. So let me, I really should probably look up the directions for how to put this together. It's probably what I should do before I bend it into the wrong shape. I mean, I'm pretty sure I know the correct shape. Let me get my tweezers. Thank you. Yeah, the story of the abandoned coffee shop was one that kind of developed while I was creating it. So it wasn't something that I was like, okay, this is the story and now I'm going to create something based off of it. It was something that developed as I was building the abandoned coffee shop. The abandoned coffee shop originally started as a guild project. So I'm part of a miniature guild that's local to this area, and everyone was supposed to make a coffee shop, and I was brand new to the guild, didn't know anybody, really knew one person, and I was like, okay, well, I guess I'm gonna make an abandoned coffee shop because that's kind of my style. And I started working on it, and I kind of skipped the first few steps that I did, and then I had already started my YouTube channel, and I'm like, why am I not recording this for YouTube? And so I started recording the building of the abandoned coffee shop, like, after the walls were already up. That's why I kind of show you how to make the brick walls, but it's just like on a separate piece. And then the story just kind of developed from there as I put things into it. Let's see. I haven't heard of Hammy Hamster. Have you heard of bullet journaling? Yes, I have heard of bullet journaling. I have a calendar that I use, and I don't think that I'm organized enough, I guess I should say, to sit down and create my own calendar. Like, I love seeing when people do it because usually they're incredibly beautiful. Okay, I need to look up the directions for this because I don't know what I'm doing now. But I don't think I would be very good at sitting down and drawing out my own calendar. I like that it's, like, already done for me in the calendar that I use. I need a drink of water. Okay. So, you know what? Before we get to this, there is a piece that I can cut out that we can just test and see if we like it. So we'll do that first. Bye, cat. When my kids were little, they had those Polly Pocket things for girls and something for boys. I think it was Mad Max. It was Max something. I have Polly Pockets, the ones that I had when I was a kid. They're over there, sitting on a shelf, because they're antiques now, basically. story of two little mice live in a mansion with all kinds of other little mice, much calmer than Dear Hammy. Huh. Have you seen the 12-scale Hobbit house? I have not. Who made that? You have to let me know. I'm going to cut out this little window and door piece, and then we can kind of put it on and decide if we like it. Because I don't want to go through the trouble of putting a ton of gold stuff on and then it being a little bit too much. But I guess we can always kind of dull the gold down, or we can put green on it to make it look like copper type colors. Okay. Let's see. If you weather some of the gold with patina. See, Kim, you and I thinking alike. All right, so these openings right here correspond with this piece, which I was supposed to put on before I glued this piece on. So that's why this is so difficult. If you follow the directions in the correct order, it's not this difficult. But I did not. It actually kind of blends in a little bit. It just gives it a little bit of shine. Because it's gold paper, I think. So let me know what you think. So I think it's okay. And we can always go back over it. I might glue this one in. But I need a different set of tweezers to use it because that set wasn't very helpful. All right, let me get a glue cap and some glue. And so we have about 30 minutes left in our stream, and I know because my stomach's growling. My granola bar has worn off. Okay, so I've got a little bit of tacky glue. And let me get another set of tweezers. It's going to be a little bit better for this. Micro machines. I remember micro machines. I have a couple dozen, or I like having a dozen projects in progress. I can shift from one to another according to mood. Yep, same. It won't let me post the link to the Hobbit Hole. It's Mads Hobbit Hole on WordPress. Okay, I'll have to look that up. Thank you. Yeah, it didn't even show me that you... Sometimes it shows me if people try to post a link, and then I can approve it if it's something I want, but it didn't even show me. So, you never know with YouTube. You can always share things on my Facebook page also if you are on Facebook. So, you can go to the community tab and then just post it. Alright, I don't know if y'all can hear my stomach. So I'm just going to put a little bit of glue around the edges of this piece. And we'll get it glued on, and then we'll at least have this piece on. We can decide if it needs to be aged or if it's good. This, I'm guessing, is the door to the captain's quarters. I wish this was... it's already small enough. I wish it was just a little bit smaller so that I could actually put it into the captain's quarters, into his ship collection, but I think it's just a little bit too big, which is super sad. But I think it would take up a lot of space that I could use to put other details and other miniatures in. Bye! Thanks for stopping in. I think in these chats, only moderators can post links unless she does something on her end. Hi, Matt Gaming. My brother had the huge submarine playset from Micro Machines. I had to put those stickers on with tweezers. My goodness. I don't think Polly Pocket had stickers. I don't remember putting stickers on, but it's been years, so... All right, so I've glued it in there. We'll let the glue dry a bit. I think it does add a little something. A little something. I'll cut out the one for this piece as well, and we can see how that looks. Our little angel on the pirate ship. Does the black pearl have an angel on the front? That seems strange. Hi, Ash. Hi, Sheila. I have kits in my store right now. I have the Hall Tree and the Hoosier Cabinet are the two I have right now. I'm working on making the stove into a kit. I have a half-scale Hall Tree in there, and I have to redo my shutters kit. So that one's not in there right now, but it will be back in there soon. So... All right, so this is what this looks like. If I add this guy on. Nope, he didn't want to go on. Okay. All right, well, tweezer time. All right. There we go. Let's see if I can turn it around without it falling off. Da-da-da-da! What do you think? As compared, I mean, like I said, we could age it a little bit and make it look like maybe it was once brass and now it's kind of old looking. What do y'all think? Glue on the angel or don't glue on the angel? That sounded sinister. Glue on the angel or don't glue on the angel? So I will wait to see some responses on whether we like that or not. I think it's okay. I think it's definitely bright, and I think it'd be okay if we aged it a bit. I have to get some, like, green paint or something. I don't understand how you're wearing a long sleeve shirt with layers because it's really hot in Texas right now. My significant other keeps the house pretty cold. So, yeah. This is how I survive. Okay. All right. I'm seeing a lot of glue it and age it. Perfect answer. Glue it and age it. All right. Let's see. My cat's birthday was a 5th. Happy birthday to your cat. My Stormy's birthday, her first birthday, is coming up on soon. She's got a May birthday. So we're gonna have a little tiny celebration for Stormy, who's turning 1. Okay, now it's kind of stuck to my finger. Let's get it stuck to the ship instead of my finger. There we go. And I got glue on the paper, so that will help age the paper. It won't be as shiny. Cut her wings off? Well, I would, except the wing is helping it. This wing is attached here, and so it's helping this not be so flimsy. So I think I kind of need to keep it. I don't know if I want it to be an evil ship. I think if it was an evil ship, it would be even more sinister if it had an angel on it. That would even make me more worried, honestly. It's like it's masquerading as an angel, but it's not. Okay, let me put this one on this side. Yeah, I think I'll put the glue on the ship part this time. And then we'll get this guy stuck on. And then I'll go get some green. Oh, I got glue on it anyway. That's all right. We'll be 2 on the 28th. Aw. Lots of fur babies born in May. Okay, let me go get some green real quick. All right. Which green? We got Aira's avocadoiest avocado and citrus. I'm thinking probably the avocado. So I'm just going to put a dot. I'm not going to put too much because I am going to use a little bit of water on this paint just to water it down a little bit. Let's see. Onyx will be 3 on June 24th and Opal will be 3 on July 9th. Aww. Okay, y'all are on the same page as me. Yeah, we might do both greens. We'll see. Okay. I'm putting just a little bit of green. Y'all can't see it. A little bit of green with some water. And I'm just going to kind of brush it on top. And I guess it's got some kind of film on this paper because it's kind of pooling up. So I'm going to kind of see how it reacts just a little bit before I go any further. Yeah, we might do a little bit of teal on it too, like you said. Thank you, Sheila. So we'll, maybe I'll blow on it. Try not to blow on the microphone. Wow. How do we jump up to 170 viewers? Hi, everybody. I don't know when that happened, but hello. You can make kelp at the bottom. Well, this is actually going to be a flying ship. So a ship in the air. So what would be the air equivalent? That's the word I'm looking for. Air equivalent to kelp. That'd be leaves, I guess. So that kind of dulled the paper down a little bit. Let me play around with some not watered down paint and we'll try that. So I'll get a little bit of teal. We have plenty of it anyway. And I'm just going to go on the edges first. Got to steady my hands a little bit here. Start out light and then add more as needed. I'm just going to go around the edge with the blue first and then we can come back with it. So I don't know if y'all be able to see that. So it's starting to look a little bit older. Muffin has 2 birthdays, her actual birthday, Christmas Eve, and her gotcha day in April. Some clouds, dead birds, oh no. Air plants, oh yeah, I've seen those. Trailing clouds, bird feathers, oh my goodness. Sandbags hanging on the rope, that would be a great detail. Haven't painted in 2 months. I love painting, but it is kind of hard to sit down and just focus on painting something. So I'm thankful for a live stream where I get to make time specifically for working on this. So let me go back with some green now on top of the blue. It's getting really tiny. I'm just going to dab it with my finger so you don't see any brush marks. So that kind of looks like an kind of like an old piece of metal, maybe. Let me know what y'all think. Add propellers over the ship. That would be cool too. We could add so many details. Oh my goodness. Vanessa. Yeah, this would be so, so tiny. Bits of rope dangling off the boat, moss or lichen. I like the rope dangling. That would be a good one. What about dock bumpers? Yeah, I think in Stardust, the movie, he does land in the water because they get off at a dock. So he is in the water for a while. Like I said, I'm not trying to completely copy that ship, but, you know, as there are no real life references to air boats like this, I guess I could look up blimps. If blimps are in the air for a long amount of time, what is stuck to the side of them when they return? I'm not sure that would, any Google results would come up for that. Painting can be a pain when it's really tiny. I couldn't find a small enough pointy brush, so I use an old eyeliner. Hey, that's a good idea. Yeah, some of those eyeliner brushes are really small. All right, so I'm going to do the same thing on this side. Get that all aged up. Oops, I just hit the microphone. Okay. Dab it with my fingers. If you dab paint with your fingers, sometimes it'll help break up any lines, something you don't, if you don't want it looking too perfect. So, yeah, I can see how it doesn't quite look like an angel. I think that's what it's supposed to be. But I'll have to go look what is actually on the front of the Black Pearl, because I think this is what this is supposed to be. Oh, Treasure Planet. That's a good one to look up. Can you make a cannon, and in the next live stream you make a UFO and they're both fighting in the air? That's a fun idea. Bird poop and bird guts. Kite strings and old balloons. Buy almost anything, YouTube. Happy birthday, Donita. I hope you have a really good one. Yesterday was my sister's birthday, so happy birthday to my sister yesterday. Crushed bugs. Honestly, we have been having enough gnats that I could put real crushed bugs on this thing. It's something about the spring, all the gnats wake up and show up in front of my face while I'm trying to work on something. A guy snagged on a rope. My goodness. I just found your channel the other day and I'm obsessed. I've always loved minis, but I've never made anything. I've only collected minis for printers, drawers. Thank you for sharing. Well, welcome to the channel, Nancy. Okay, so that's what that looks like. I think I will try to fold this guy and see if we can make that work. We have about less than 10 minutes left, and then I gotta go eat and make sure the family ate. And so we'll see if we can figure this out real quick. Okay, so I'll show you what I'm looking at. This is this piece right here. And I guess there's a black colored piece that needs to go around it. And then there's these supports that go on the bottom. This looks complicated. And then this whole thing goes on the back. Right here. So that's why this part looks so plain, because this is supposed to be stuck on there. And I didn't do it because I didn't know if I was gonna do the gold or not, but I think we'll give it a go. So here's this gold piece. Let me see if I can find the black piece that goes on it too. I always do this with kits. I always get about 60% through a kit, and then I just stop following the directions and start doing my own thing. And then I'm like, why can't I find any of the pieces? Oh, because I stopped following directions a while ago. It's snowing. My goodness. Oh, hot air balloons. The spear could spike. We're just going to have all the stuff hanging off the bottom of the ship. A good book with flying airships is the Harbinger series by Jeff Wheeler. Stormglass is the first of the series. Very Dickensian. That was hard to say. Dickensian. Strong female characters. Cool. I'll have to check that out. I think I've heard of that. The Harbinger series. All right. I found the piece that goes with it. I'm going to cut it off. Without trying to mess it up too much. Did I get it? Nope. Honestly, the connections that are holding the pieces in are so small, they're impossible to see. Impossible. All right. Here we go. And then these must be the little support pieces right here. Whoops. I bent that a little too much. Okay, so this piece goes on here. So I kind of like that it's not like completely gold. That definitely breaks it up a little bit more. But I think that looks pretty nice. So I think I'll paint this here. Or I won't paint it. I'll glue it. The black pearl has an angel in what looks like a rumpled sheet holding a bird ready to fly. Is that what this is supposed to be? Is that supposed to be for Jack Sparrow, I guess? Because I don't know what this is supposed to be. I don't know. Is it holding a pot? A book? What is it holding? A bell? So that must make sense. That makes sense, Jude. So this is a generic kit, and it was called the Black Pirate Ship, and I was just guessing it was supposed to be based off of the Black Pearl, but it's not called the Black Pearl. Alright, so let me glue this guy on here. And I don't know if we'll get it completely glued on, but we'll at least be able to see what it looks like. And then we can make decisions about what we want to do with the ship in the next stream. And how far, like how much y'all want me to do off camera or what. Because I don't want y'all to be bored, but I also don't want to do too much. And then y'all be like, well, how'd you do that? So, but I think I'm enjoying this for a live stream project. I hope you guys are too. And I will be getting back to the cardboard house this week. So probably this weekend, I will be starting to make some more cardboard furniture. And I've really been having fun with that. Making some more patterns for you guys so you guys can keep making cardboard furniture. It's amazing how quickly already a lot of y'all have been putting together the couch and getting started on houses. And so I've been enjoying seeing that. Yeah, it does look completely different. And I'm very much happier with it. And I think you can see the details a little bit better too. All right, so I'm just gonna glue this on. Try to line up the windows with the openings. This is it's a very well cut and very well cut and organized. Is that what I want to say? It goes together just like it says in the directions. So I will say that. It's a little fiddly and a little hard to get everything exactly the way you want it, but it does go together exactly like it says. So props to Paper Nano for that. Yesterday we woke up to find an inch of snow on the ground. Oh my goodness. Thankfully it melted by the end of the day. What time is it at your place? It is almost 1 o'clock. All right, let me see how this goes together. Okay, those get flipped in. All right, can do. These flip in like so. Oof, I don't want to rip anything. These flip in. And I think I could probably add the rope pieces for next time too. Probably we should do the sails next time. I don't know, what do y'all think? Okay, so let me push these down. So I'll kind of show you what this looks like. And I'll, drop it. Here we go. Of course, it looks a little bit better than this once it's put on properly. But it kind of sits on the back of the ship like so. And then this is folded in. Like that. Not perfect at the moment, but... but I think it does, it definitely helps because this is so plain back here. Adding these pieces right here just makes it look so much more detailed. So I think I'll stop right there and I'll add this before next time because that's going to take some concentration. There's so many little flaps on there. I'll add this and I'll possibly add the ropes because that looks like it's going to take a lot of concentration without me paying attention or with me paying full attention here, so I won't be able to talk really well while I'm working on these guys. So I think I'll finish putting that on, I'll do the ropes, and then I'll come up with a plan for the sails, and then we can, I'll save at least one or two of the sails for us to do together next time. And that's not part of the kit, so that's something that you could possibly use in another project. And then I'll try and have like a box already put together for the scene, and then we can start to decide what the scene's going to look like. So let me know if you guys think that sounds like a plan. I really like making a plan with you guys before the next one, because y'all are here, y'all are watching it. Haven't, you know, enjoying the stream, so I want to make sure that the next stream is something you guys will really like also. She knows the ropes. I don't know them yet. I will work on it for next time. Thank you guys for being here and hanging out with me today. I really do enjoy the live streams because I get to talk back and forth with you live and hear how you're doing. Thank you, Jennifer. Thank you, Leslie. So that's it for this stream. The next stream will be the second Friday of next month, unless schedules, you know, schedules kind of get crazy nowadays. But I'll let you guys know full well in advance. I like to put up the live stream reminder pretty early so as many people can see it as possible. So, oh, Gail says maybe try some sale possibilities beforehand, then we can decide which looks best. That's a good idea, because I could show you guys what I tried out, since so many of you guys gave me some good suggestions. It's a good idea. Bye, y'all. If you're far away, have a good night's sleep. If you're near, have a good afternoon. And if you're not either one of those, have a good morning. Time zones are so confusing. Y'all have a good day. We're at whatever time it is, y'all have a good day. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.